Keep it on tap.
That's a fact, bro. He has to make sure that, you know, when he get out, he has a fresh batch weed for him.
It's not even that.
He probably bought himself a couple of babies.
Shit, that's probably the best life some of them bitches from Chicago ever had, nigga. Or anywhere else out there. Ooh,
R. Kelly came. That is a fact.
It's a fact.
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And they like, fuck that. I'm not leaving there. I'll wait till you come home. Because I don't know, man. You know. I'm just saying.
And then honestly, it's women that's just into that shit.
Are we really up there? We starting to record? Is that it?
Yeah, see?
Yo, we still rolling.
How niggas go all the way back to R. Kelly's and this is still a popular topic of discussion today, bro?
It's always going to be a popular topic.
That motherfucker, the Pied Piper.
That motherfucker.
In the closet.
Him and Bill Cosby.
Mm-hmm. Oh, my God.
That is a fact.
My son, Bill.
There was in the closet. Word, there was in the closet because it was gay. There was in the closet for some other shit.
If you're over 30, you definitely got ass to R. Kelly.
Like Kelly.
Say that again?
I said, if you're over 30, you definitely got ass to R. Kelly.
I played the PT2 album, too.
I swear to God. You know, I remember I was at work, I tried to play one R. Kelly song, but the bitch pulled up. She said, yo, that nigga is canceled. Go get your ass out of here.
Whoa, yeah, you can't play that shit now.
Play none of his shit no more, bro. That nigga is canceled.
That shit went from groove music to rape music.
Word.
Kind of shit needs to be making.
Could have said it better myself.
Can't be saying better myself, bro. Trapped in the closet.
Hold up, wait a minute.
Y'all thought I was finished? Smacked her on her back.
Hey, what you said, Neef? What you said? Hold up, wait a minute.
That's terrible.
I never said no shit at all. Hold up, wait a minute.
And she a treesh, nigga.
In the
Mendo, in limbo, we're going limbo.
What's that? Ain't that? What's that? Hold, wait.
Yeah.
Ain't that your Betty running through the city? Or everybody?
What'd you say before that?
The first line.
The first line.
Hey, ain't that your Betty?
Oh, all
right. Running through the city. Oh, everybody busy. Ain't she a chizzy? Caught her in a bando.
What?
With a
rando. What?
Go a Rambo.
Hands on her ankles.
She's back. Give it top.
I don't like that song.
On the
back.
To the
eye. You don't like that. You don't like that.
You
woke up this morning like, yo, I hate that song.
That wasn't this morning. That was like 2 days ago.
That was every day.
My son was in his bag, bro. I looked at the text in the morning, and I was like,
I think it was just goofy, you know what I'm saying? Yo, I don't really talk about shit like that, you feel me? That's not about my life. I am not about that new nigga world type shit. But I'm just trying to be
on him in the fucking group chat. I'm like, what the fuck?
I need to hear this shit.
Alright, is this shit recording?
That shit is recording, Dave.
Alright, that's been recording.
Okay.
We call all of that.
You're damn right.
Caught your big ass head on camera too. You know half your head is spinning the screen right now?
That is insane.
Yo, bro.
Stop playing. You don't fix that shit, man. Bye, Ed.
I was looking at it and I was trying not to say nothing until the last moment, bro.
You were a motherfucker.
Eddie put the hat on with it, too.
Wait, I think that go the other way.
Go to me.
All right, so where we starting
with? Does anybody have anything to...
What are we starting with?
We're going to start with a little today. Bit of blood right here.
What are we going to start off with today?
No, you know what? Bless said yes, he had two topics he want to talk about.
That's a fact.
That's a fact.
So, you want to bring the show in today?
Let's start it in.
Sure. Blunt Vision, what's going on, everybody? You already know today. It's your boy, Bless Man, BL355, once again here with the gang. I'm going to let everybody introduce themselves. Starting with Finesse.
What's going on? Y'all know who it is. Who it look like? It's your boy, D Finesse. A.K.A. Mr. 7 Days a Week, A.K.A. the Wolf Street Heathen, A.K.A. the motherfucking MacGyver, nigga, I'm in this bitch.
He ain't fixing
that. I'm about to fuck out of his
that shit.
We ain't shooting none of that yet. All right, we started.
He's got it.
Yeah.
He's got it, but let's get that running one more time.
Yeah, let's do it again. That was good.
Which way is this going?
That's going to your boy. Okay. BL355.
All right, so today we're sponsored by Purple Platinum. You heard? Get your pre-rolls coming to you soon. You feel me? You know, I always got to promote something, right? So today we promoting Purple Platinum. You're going to be enjoying this Purple Platinum across some Blunt Vision and Conversation. You feel me? So who's up for some Purple Platinum today?
We definitely is.
I haven't tasted this strand yet, but you know.
Yeah.
Heard it was a great strand.
Oh, but definitely.
But definitely
today,
be here.
Today, I definitely want to speak about a couple of things. Like, I mean, like, the media's been going retarded over Usher.
We in the building. Kingpin over here. Y'all know the vibe. Retro millennial shit. You feel me? S-Star sound shit. Fresh out the dirt shit. You know.
Yeah, man.
My man gonna kick it off tonight for y'all. So you ready? Y'all already know.
Definitely. More or less, man. Bless y'all. Already know. BL355, man. Here. Kingpin in it like we do always, all day and every day. What's up?
What up?
Yo.
Yo.
The fuck was that?
Everybody, you know, we're gonna run like we did the first episode. Yeah. And we introduce ourselves for y'all. We might not record us the first time.
That means it was on to you.
You feel me? So we're gonna go around the room and we're gonna reintroduce ourselves. And, you know, yeah, we're gonna kick it off on Mr. Finesse, like my homie said over here. You feel me?
All right, yeah, y'all know who it is. Who it look like. That's your boy, Lee Finesse, a.k.a. the Wolf Street Heathen. A.K.A. Mr. 7 Days a Week, A.K.A. motherfucking MacGyver, I'm in this bitch.
A.K.A. shut the fuck up.
Sauce on him.
Let's not do it like that, bro. That's my man.
See,
I'm about to
start setting shit up so we can have the... And all the, you know, drop sounds. You know, this is fresh, baby. Yeah, we're enjoying ourselves. So, you know, who up next?
AJ.
My man,
you already know me, AJ, but my real name, Alcine Jallo, best market promoter out here, assisted to Finesse King right here, fresh out the dirt, of course, working with the Coalition, we out here making moves, money King moves Pink. All day, Kingpin Productions all day representing, right now I'm going to hand over to my man's Dash right here, main artist, main man right here.
Alright, what up y'all, already know, I go by E-Dash Quaid and Mr. Global Warming, you know, the hottest nigga around the center of the earth. So, you know, we here once again, another week, Blunt Vision. Y'all about to sit down and visualize what the fuck this blunt smoke bring up today. Because once again, I don't fucking know. But let's do it.
Oh, yeah. But the topic I wanted to talk about today was what got the media going crazy right now. You know, this whole big thing about Usher. Somehow,
oh, shit. Usher's back in the media?
Man,
that's what happened to the dancing herpy?
What the fuck?
Yeah, but you know,
think about the moon.
You know, but the big thing now is, you know, this thing about Usher telling his kids that it's okay to cry.
So I cry.
He's telling his sons that it's okay for men to cry. And, you know, the media, from what the media is saying, is they don't feel that, you know, society teaches men that we shouldn't cry. It's a sign of weakness. But Usher feels different. So that's what, how do you feel today? I'm trying to see how, because me personally, I feel like situations count for everything. Men, yes, crying is a sign of weakness. So I don't think it should be done in front of people, you know, but, you know. They say you shouldn't cry at all.
Yeah, that's a fact.
Saying?
Yeah, crying some shit you do at 3 in the morning in the dark.
Yeah.
I can understand that from a man's perspective, I guess, you feel me? But me, I don't even give a fuck. Feel me? You know me, I don't care what niggas think about me, nobody think about me. But for children, bro, I don't think you should put a block on them, because actually it's the only way they know how to express themselves sometimes. You feel me? Their brains aren't, developed enough to sit there and have a full-blown conversation like an adult and express to you what's really going on. So sometimes an outburst, and they have these crying, and it's cold. It's okay. Even for boys, you feel me? Even for boys. But to cry for every little thing, no, that's something different. I can see if every 5 seconds, because I have a little cousin who did it, you feel me?
That's a fact.
Every time you turn around, he would cry. Even if you, know what I mean, for everything. Now, that's something different. No, that's a sign of weakness. But to show pain or suffering, like your mom's dying or some shit like that, it's a way to purify your soul and shit too, you feel me? And
not, that's a fact.
And not, you know what I mean, back up shit and hold shit in, and you do some shit dangerous later, you feel me? So it all depends on where the fuck niggas coming from with it. But that's just my take on it. You know, I don't care. I'll cry if I have to, nigga.
Yeah, you know, I just don't think that,
he got a song about this.
God damn.
I cried.
That nigga going hard.
That man going hard. Okay. All right. He with
you. I'm saying, yo.
He out here representing the crying. Tears falling and all that.
I'm saying.
Waterfalls.
So I cried.
Doing
you can cry.
In his terms of cry, from the way he's publicizing it, I don't agree with
it. I'm saying, yo. Once you hit 16,
don't
stop crying.
Don't get me wrong. Give that to my younger sons, you know, the babies, you know. Listen, man up, nigga. We're not gonna be doing this crying thing. Some things, like they say, kids are sponges, and things start at young ages. Mm-hmm. So you don't want to leave a room for something to have to get older and go back to. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? That emotional state. Oh, I can do this because it was there. So you know, sometimes you want to implement that early. Not to say not to cry, but pick and choose when to cry.
Yeah, and yeah. I gotta be saying, like, we gotta be careful how we use the term "man up" with the kids today, bro.
It's a fact.
Because it could send, you know what I mean, the wrong signal. You feel me? That, okay. Just like you said, you know what I mean?
I don't know about that, man.
You don't want them growing up to be a certain way later because of what they do. Well, you pushing man up on them is the whole reason why niggas pulling out guns, manning up, and not being suckers, and you know what I mean, and not doing a whole lot of shit because we man up.
Yeah,
and we pay the consequences, you
I
feel me?
I think they pulling out guns because the man up that
not just guns, I'm just talking about everything. You know, when nigga walk past a nigga and a nigga look at you the wrong way, you man up because you feel like, instead of saying not having a nigga moment, and keeping your day, you feel me?
You're actually saying the right thing.
You feel me?
Nigga moment.
You know?
Definitely.
So, you know.
I want to get to deeper than that. Because it's something I thought about at work. Let's talk about masculinity in society right now. How we view masculinity now. And how the generation. And how
there is none. Not my bad.
We view that shit like it's a fucking disease.
I'm saying, right? But look what you're saying. You're saying there is nothing.
Yeah, they fuck the society up, bro.
Yeah, they view that shit like a disease,
man. Has been push, like, nigga, if you do it, you go to jail. You might as well, nigga, you feel me? Anything masculine,
that,
because...
But what do you define masculinity as?
All right, here's what I mean. Masculine, as far as taking the role of the father out of the household, giving schools control of that shit, you feel me? Like, parenting, you can't discipline your children. The masculine of the home, the dominance of the home, the man's structure... Then pulled away, you feel me? By judges, by police, you feel me?
I don't necessarily.
Hold up,
there's a book that came out in 93 about that shit. About them motherfuckers destroying the family unit.
That's the fact I want to get to.
Fucking, you know.
I don't believe it's just that.
Nah, that's a big part of it, though. Because
I don't think that's a big part.
Now, look, right?
What do you mean, AJ?
The United States just got soft, bro. You feel me? The United States got soft.
You gotta straight up blame 9/11 for that shit.
You can't say things you used to say. You feel me? Or you're gonna be looked at like, you know what I mean? Everything is sensitive now. You can't tell Black Lives Matter sensitive. Homosexuality, all that shit sensitive.
That shit, it all started there, though.
Women's, if you say the wrong thing about a woman, that's very sensitive now because women empowerment is becoming a big movement as well, along as with Black. So everything is a touchy subject now. And, you know, back in the day, Richard Pryor could get the fuck up on stage and say whatever the fuck he want, joking or being serious. Paul Rooney, all them niggas, you feel me? Mm-hmm. And had the right to express themselves, you feel me? Mm-hmm. Nowadays, comedian, rapper, anybody, try to get up there and do that shit today.
That's why them motherfuckers don't play colleges no more.
Say faggot in the song.
But see, I mean, bring it back.
You just got a strike on YouTube.
Bring it back to the original topic about manning up. I think that taking that term away from the children takes away what was taken from us originally, our heritage, you know, our wildlife. Like, they took all of that from us.
Right.
You know, how to establish what's north from south, east or west, you didn't, being able to move around. That man up term, they took that from us. So we lost a little bit of all of that. And it made it easier for them to transform our young men into whatever now today.
Yeah, whatever the fuck you want to call them now and shit.
Whatever it is.
They took the man not away
even,
from them.
Even if they're not gay, they just a lot softer than we were.
They took that term from them. They took it. It's no manning up now. It's just expressing your emotions.
I don't disagree with that.
And expressing your feelings.
Again, I blame 9/11.
The whole crime?
I straight up blame 9/11 for that shit.
Yeah, safety for security.
What do you mean? Before that shit happened, no one was crying as a nation or sending their hearts out to motherfuckers.
I'm just saying the way we use the term man up should be established directly for what it's supposed to be used for instead of confusing the next generation to come out here and do worse shit than we had to do because we didn't understand what the fuck our elder niggas said when they said man up. Now, they knew what the fuck they saying exactly what you saying because it's right. You're strong. You're a man.
I mean, they had a different version of men and shit.
The way they gave it to us was different. You feel me? Exactly. And, you know, if we continue to do that, then we destined for failure. Obviously, it hasn't worked this long. You feel me? Yeah. But if we could just change the terminology of man up just a little bit for niggas to understand what that is. But actually, what the fuck is a real man? You feel me? What's the difference between, you know what I mean,
owning up, taking responsibility.
Shit like that.
That's kind of what I was alluding to.
Being a leader.
You gotta understand this, right? How many of us can say that we had real role models in our lives to teach us how to be a man in the first place?
I did. I just didn't have it at home, but I had to go outside of home to find it.
That's exactly my point. I didn't really have it until I was like 16, 17, and it was more of a mentor figure. You get what I'm saying? It was a dude that I was working for. You know what I mean? I allowed him to show me shit that I didn't understand as a man yet. You get what I'm saying? But before that, though, like, my pops was locked up when I was 8 years old and came home until I was 23.
Yeah, that's a fact. I never knew my pops, but stop playing. Yo, I had Kung Fu movies. Them niggas knew how to raise a kid.
Me personally, I had a drunken alcoholic, you know what I'm saying, that really couldn't teach me nothing, but I learned from how he moved. Even though he was an alcoholic, he was independent. He got his own. He was his own boss.
Independent Alki.
He was an alcoholic, but he was in home.
Physical dependency don't make you a worthless piece of shit. You feel me? Some niggas, you know, that's just some shit they had to come and deal with over time and in life.
I probably didn't have one that told me, hold your penis while you piss over the toilet. But I had a male figure in home that was independent and doing what he had to do as a man. He manned up whether he was drunk or sober.
Facts.
It didn't matter. You know what I'm saying? If he didn't have it, he went out there and he got it. And he never worked for nobody. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, I mean, a lot of things from him, we could probably learn from a lot of the bums on our streets. We could learn from a lot of these, because they're out there. They're in the wilderness.
Bro, I'll say it like this.
We're home.
If you can't learn from the bums on the street, know what are they there for?
That's fucked up.
Like
first life lesson
you be on, like, every conversation you have, like, is a value lesson in it. You just have to find that lesson. And the funny part is, a lot of the most educated conversations that I've had have been with people I really thought were not, had more money at all. people have been in the trains, bums in the trains.
That's because
they just
say nothing bad there.
So what are you saying? I don't have no money. I don't have educated conversations. Is that what you're saying?
That's what I'm saying.
I will cut your ass. We can definitely do this.
We gonna do this.
You know what?
I wanted to touch on something. Bless it. I kind of lost train. Back to what you were saying, bro. Not to spin off topic. While we still on this topic, I didn't have a role model around either when I was a kid, but I did have an opportunity to go to this place. I want to shout it out. It was called the Simba Nation, bro. And what they did for me was, I went to this church when I was a kid. It was a Lutheran church. And what they did was they took kids from a lot of the inner cities and urban youths that experienced fucked up childhoods and shit like that. You feel me? And they sent us to like Chicago and Minnesota, Iowa, you feel me? Shit like that. And we got to go away and we was around black niggas who was doctors and lawyers and teachers and, you feel me, scientists and shit like that, you feel me? And they actually put their own bread up for this camp every year for children, black niggas that come from LA, everywhere, bro. Chicago, Milwaukee, New York, New Jersey, Kansas City. So it was called Simba Nation, you feel me? And every year it was like 250 of us, boys, black boys. We got to come,
all
black camp, bro. And we got to come over there with niggas who did shit that I never even got to even fathom in my brain was possible. Feel me? I got to really be with a nigga who was a doctor, or a lawyer, you know what I mean? Or real rappers, like, you know what I mean? People who own studios and shit like that. And they were at our grass, and they just showed us shit like, you know, black niggas can be positive. We can say, yo, I love you, my brother type shit, you feel me? Because you my black brother type shit, you feel me? We can't all live in one society and actually do something positive and raise our youth up to be positive black niggas too, you feel me? Excuse my French.
Excel in life, you feel me? Us as black people have to learn the fact that we have so much power in our hands.
Long story short, they lost funding, you feel me? Because I've been looking for them for like the last 10 years. You know, Gaylord Thomas, Sean McMillan.
I wasn't with Simba, but I went to the Fresh Air Fund.
Really?
Fresh Air Fund. Fresh Air Fund is... Minority mixed, just that, you know, it's targeted more to low income homes.
I went to that shit, man.
And I had fun.
They didn't send me with some white family called the Mets List.
I've been through that shit.
We did things like
this shit was
another
level, bro. We had
like some town and shit like
yeah,
threw me in a fucking room with some cat named Carl.
I was going to say, to elaborate off of what you were saying.
Carl.
They have other programs out there. Like, you got Big Brother programs, have sophisticated...
so that's the type of shit we got to start implementing back into our community.
Yeah, they have them. They also even now, but they got now the fatherhood programs.
Yeah.
The fatherhood programs actually consist of individuals, black individuals, a lot of them, that were successful, independent black fathers. You dig what I'm saying?
Okay.
So there's a lot of programs that are out there that we can actually connect with.
Yeah, we definitely need to do
because
something.
Because even though, like you said, Simba
Simba Nation ran out of funding,
we could probably bring it back.
Best thing that ever happened,
you know,
bro.
But there's some out there that we can actually guide people until we make that. We can guide people to other networks.
And I think
a couple of them.
You definitely got to do that, bro.
Around,
anybody out there know any networks? My bad, bro. Not cutting you off. Y'all link us and let us know. Hit us up. Any, you know, foundations like that. Y'all know of any places like that. Hit us up. Let us know. We're definitely trying to get in tune. But, my bad.
Yeah, we can elaborate off of Usher and the cry situation? We can move forward. Let's move forward. The next topic I want to talk about.
Usher in the cry situation almost got motherfuckers in here crying.
My next topic is a little more serious, a little more serious and intense, you know.
What we got?
I'm going to elaborate on this new tweet that Kanye West sent out to his daughter.
What?
About that?
Stop playing. What president Kanye had to say?
Oh, yeah, this place is about him going for presidency, too, and
all
that.
Or,
but,
still.
He sent a tweet to his daughter speaking about how he felt that his life was in danger and that if he was to get, he's going to war, and that if he was to get killed today or tomorrow, he wanted his daughter to know that his daddy loves her, and if she was to hear a white man tell her one day that
that he wasn't a good person, that he was alive. Now, you know, that was kind of like, it kind of like...
That motherfucker off his meds again.
That's sort of what his, but is he really though?
Yeah, that's the question.
Mm-hmm. Right, is he really?
Like, why did he go out of his way to even write something that long on Twitter and publicize it? Like, I mean, he did a lot of shit, but that's kind of personal.
Okay, so
motherfuckers are all losing their lines on Twitter right now.
This doesn't surprise me from Kanye.
But I'm saying, look,
the reason why I say that, because Kanye has a tendency when he goes into depression shit to say sporadic shit like this.
That's not depression.
Is it sporadic or is it?
Because he does sporadic shit.
Is it depressing because I allowed it to go on for so long and I didn't say
Kanye West tweets did the
why would he say that? Listen. He said, if a white man tell you that I wasn't good, don't look.
The tweet. You could go to the tweet.
You see it?
Nah, he deleted it.
It's still up there because I was just looking.
He then deleted the disturbing message to his daughter, going to war for her.
The tweet is up there though. The one that he.
Somebody probably screenshotted it.
I mean, the whole thing is just like that. They took it down 24 hours ago.
Oh, that's crazy.
Before we did this meet. So I know it's up there.
That's crazy.
Like, let me look at the picture.
Yeah, somebody probably took a picture of it.
Of course they took a picture of it.
But why would he go out his way to just do, you know what I mean? Just go all the way in like that, bro?
Of course, that's what people are doing right now. That's what the people are doing right now. Everyone's going crazy. Like, Kanye right now is probably, like, fucked up with everything going on in the news right now.
So, yeah, I think it's daytime. It's time for them to move out the way, and it's time for the next of them puppets to step up.
Is that the tweet?
These niggas getting old or something?
Shit. Speaking of news, that fucking cat from that Netflix show got caught with kiddie porn.
What?
Yeah.
What cat?
Neef.
Who's up?
Look up, Netflix actor gets caught with child pornography. Wow. Got another one now. Smallmongers in Hollywood are terrible.
Burning.
Like, seriously.
I'm sorry, man. Burning. Babies don't deserve none of that shit, man.
Tell me, that's why Hillary lost. Them motherfuckers saw all those goddamn emails with that bitch. Huh?
That pizza party shit was real?
Yo, tell me, yeah. I said I knew from Netflix.
Jerry Harris?
Yo, bro, y'all saw a new movie from Netflix.
Cheer?
Yeah. Yep, from Cheer.
It's working called Cuties.
Nah. Fuck no.
First of all,
bro, that controversial ass movie that everybody's talking about right now.
That fucking pedophile shit?
Pedophile ass movie,
but,
bro,
look it.
They have little ass 12-year-olds twerking, bro.
Yeah.
I don't even watch it.
Seriously, no jokes. They got that shit. It was like, what the fuck?
Out of here.
The fuck is wrong? The director's like, oh, we did that to bring light to people right sexualizing little girls. Like, you don't do that by showing little bitches.
Did you get any of these, bro?
Huh?
Did you get any of these?
Get that one.
I don't know if they ever hit your side, bro. Make sure you get one in the head.
So, yeah, look at motherfucker. Some motherfucker that works for Netflix. An actor. First of all, this nigga's playing a male cheerleader. I ain't down with that. And he gets caught with child porn. Like, bruh.
It's right there. Yeah.
What the fuck?
What's wrong with these rich motherfuckers? See, we gotta just start boiling down. This shit is a bunch of shit that niggas...
Yeah,
if you have money, you can do whatever the fuck you want. Ain't no niggas with no money doing shit like bruh. Like this, man.
If ever there came the time when motherfucking rich people came through... I draw the line at eating a child.
I see this all self-esteem issues, my nigga. How you going and looking at shit like this, bro? How you going and looking at shit like this, bro? This all self-esteem issues. How you that downgraded low to look at shit like this, bro?
Wait,
it's disgusting,
you're
my nigga.
A movie star, bro.
On
you
Netflix.
Can have any woman you want, pretty much, bro. What the fuck are you interested in kids for?
This is daily.
You can't. It's not understandable. That's what I'm saying.
I don't understand. We ain't found no clips.
We can't find it.
I found it in the Daily News. I typed it in Google. Look. Right here. You know what I'm saying?
Is that Trump shit? I mean, on Kanye shit?
Yeah.
Look. Every time I hear Kanye,
that's what he just looked
Trump.
Up. The Daily Mail. The actual tweet is gone, though.
Kanye West. Tweets his daughter.
So what do you think he was trying to say with that? So I think he's just playing into the narrative now.
I really don't know. I haven't been following up on Kanye, honestly.
I don't follow up on him no more.
I think that Kanye's been leaking a lot of...
Because, I mean, shit.
Information that he wants that he wants to...
I know black people that would say he wasn't a good person.
That's how I look at it. Like, I think that he's really giving up too much information and his life is really on the line. The fact that he publicizes it is what's keeping him alive.
So who's in danger?
The government.
Yeah. Really? How? Everybody knows a motherfucker crazy ass shit, right?
I'm saying, why would the government? What is
even back in the day when he went and said, "Yo, Bush doesn't care about black people." I know nobody took that shit seriously.
I'm not gonna hold you. He probably knows someone.
My thing is, who?
Because he got close to Donald Trump over the years.
He knows too much. He knows too much from who though?
Yo, Snoop Dogg was on camera saying Donald Trump is my nigga.
Who?
Yeah, yep, back in the days. Yep. Nowadays, you all like fuck Trump and blah blah blah. Like it's all part of the narrative.
Yeah, they have to do that. Nigga Trump, yeah, that motherfucker.
See, I'm from New York. I can say fuck Trump because since back in the day, fuck that.
Yeah, before he was president, nigga, he ain't never do shit for us, bro.
Real motherfuckers be acting like he's Mr. New York and shit.
Now, I really believe there's gonna be a switch in the next few years. Yeah. We're gonna see. We're gonna see a crazy shit in the next 4 years.
So, yo, bro, what's up? Let's pull up our music radio real quick. Let's reveal this song, man.
Alright. Here we go. North.
Hey, what's up, baby? What's going on? How are you?
Unique, you hit this?
I'm glad you're here, bro. I was just
saying. I was cracking. I definitely didn't. What's going on? It's my boy Dash.
Heartbreaks this morning, man.
Your Dash.
What up, man?
This is for you from Atlantic City. I know you're gonna get some jokes with it.
Rub on those.
It's your studio cup.
Yes, sir.
Studio cup.
My man Dave.
What's up? Straight up, straight up.
Get some love.
Drake Turner was good in the house.
Appreciate you, Dave.
Leave being garbage as usual. Look at Prince with no shirt, don't know why. Yo, Neve. Man, cut that bullshit out.
Yo, my nigga, I'm over here. Motherfucker, I just wrote this shit.
Right here.
I just wrote this shit today, my nigga. I'm trying to get this fucking verse down so I can move on to the next verse or the hook.
That's just from Atlantic City.
Oh, thank you.
Studio Cup.
This the studio
that,
cup?
That's a studio cup for you.
I thought I was going to be able to take this home.
That, you like can. You could take it home. That's all you.
You like titties?
No.
Of course he doesn't like titties.
He doesn't like titties. He's
for the boss. For the boss, y'all. Fuck you. Fuck you for the boss.
Yeah, I know,
the boss gets the middle finger. Look at him.
And this is the number of his burnt chest.
Alongside Kingpin Production.
Take a look at his souvenir. Souvenir, go fuck yourself.
It's all right, though. At least I got it unwanted in here.
Listen, this is what we're going to do, right? We're just going to keep this right here on this table. And every time you get on our nerves, we're just going to point to that shit. Be like, yo, Prince, look. That right there. You see that, Prince?
that's my grandma's last name. You don't got my Instagram name?
No.
How you
don't
got me on Instagram?
I never had your Instagram. Hey, you got an underscore, though.
See what I'm talking about? This is why I get to be such a...
Excuse me, Miss Rivera. Do it got an underscore, a dot, or anything in it?
No. It's Diamond. My last name is Rivera. That's my grandma's last name.
I forgot you have two last names.
Yeah, I use my mom, Watson, and I use my dad, Edwin. But my grandma's last name is Rivera.
Fuck you, Dave. Really?
I got a lot of alias names.
Stay away from me.
I have a lot of personalities. Which one do you want to meet?
Not the crazy one.
Let me fix my damn body.
Bring that ass here. That lion. Bring that ass here. This better not be the Bieber video. It's not the Bieber.
Stop playing. That's a fucking ad.
You found Prince's cousin.
You're not gonna get signed
out the TV? Because of HDMI?
You found Prince's cousin.
Probably. Because it's not.
Soundbar.
Huh?
Soundbar
is hooked
to the TV. If y'all had to cut on the soundbar, we'd have had sound coming out of the TV.
It's all good.
You know, we back on? We live?
We
You think you know everything now?
We're live. Shit, right? Mm-hmm. We're
back on. Since we live, I need a light.
Who is...
Oh, nigga, I know these
who's little who's doing the intro?
That shit like it's squeezing your brain, nigga. This nigga brain got one of them, what is that? A white belt? You know what I'm saying? Green belt?
So come on, man. Bring it out,
I had it fucked up.
She got that Wakanda, like that.
Roast session every week is a must. You feel me? If you ain't been roasted.
Let's talk about somebody's ball spot in a minute.
Uh-oh. Ooh. That's fucked up. Look how the light catches that shit.
Bing!
That shit like a landmark.
Yo, why?
That's like a Bermuda Triangle, nigga.
Hey, that enters the
Alright, so what the fuck is going on with this?
It's just
spinning
around the
board. Dealing with shitty Wi-Fi in the studio?
How is that
what is this?
That's not even possible.
All right, wait. You got the volume up on your shit? Yeah, like, the volume for that, right?
Your whole life.
Yeah. That's it.
You brought your speaker?
All right, what the fuck is this, man?
Woo!
How the hell your laptop automatically
hooked
up to my speaker, nigga?
Oh, you know what's a good thing about it?
We're
gonna
what?
Get all
of
it through
the
Why
thought
on my speaker?
Mm-hmm. Huh? Why thought on my speaker? So I could, like, sync it up later with the actual video, but still, what the fuck is going on? Yo, hold up. One second. We really supposed to believe that this nigga could work in some kind of construction gig? Yeah. No, stop playing.
Not happening.
This is already not believable.
Where the fire at?
What the fuck?
Okay, I don't like it.
Can we
turn it off? Yeah, it seems like the computer don't like it either.
I don't like this shit already.
Dave, what is going on, Dave? What you doing, bro? What's going on, Dave?
Yo, he said grab something that was trending.
Probably the worst shit ever.
He said grab something that was trending. It was in the top three.
It came out 21 hours ago.
Bro, it was in the top three, bro.
It was something else.
It was this and that.
God damn.
This lit, let me
see what I'm cut your ass like that.
I ain't even hit him.
Whoa. This is 2 weeks late, like your hairline. Whoa. That's what he said.
Yeah, that's a fact, yo. The song is exactly like your hairline. Hot garbage.
Bleep is emotional, man. Y'all ain't gonna direct the music.
Oh my God.
That's why he's in his feelings. He's feeling holy.
Yo.
Holy. Oh,
come on, man.
That's these fucked guys, up.
Bro. What am I going to do with you guys, bro?
I have no idea.
Somebody give him a hug.
Yo, but who is he kidding with the fucking hard hat? Like, yo, this is the pussiest thing in the world, yo.
Yeah.
The fuck is wrong with him?
Like a YMCA video.
Yeah. What the
Colonel
Sanders in it?
Colonel Sanders is here.
Finger looking good. Get this fucking property fixed.
Yeah, why the only black guy got a wig wearing a bandana?
Some racist shit.
For real.
Ain't gotta have a cowboy hat. Wow.
Looks like the black guy ain't have no friends.
His only friend is Justin Bieber. He really has
Corona
no friends.
Had a look.
Notice how he got a black
girl. That's how fucked up this shit looks like. That's what be with Corona looks like.
This nigga mustache though.
The Biebs video.
Yeah, his mustache is probably Justin Bieber laid across his lips.
Damn, our video was better than this.
This is a horrible song and video, bro.
Yeah, how the fuck is Chance the Rapper? Exactly. How
did Chance do it to us, though?
How does this thing get 11 million views?
Already.
Fucking Justin Bieber and Chance. How don't you?
Turn it off.
What?
Turn it off wrong.
What?
Turn it off.
Turn it off? Next video? Let's do another video.
That's not Chance.
Stop playing.
Singing? Yo, what's wrong with you, Lee? Don't you embarrass us? Don't embarrass Chance like this. Come on now.
See? Chance started fucking up. You wanna know where Chance fucked up? When he was in Lion King. That motherfucker was playing a Bush baby. I was like, yeah, that was wrong to begin with. But
he was fucking
yeah, this motherfucker, man. I think, you know how I think fucked him up? D Smoke, bro. Ever since he seen D Smoke perform, bro, Chance was trying to reach that nigga level, bro. And D Smoke ain't even on, you know what I mean, a fame level as Chance. But he came into that motherfucking arena and the video selection and shit that this nigga did was of this fucking level, you feel me? And ever since then, I seen Chance videos kind of like.
I can honestly say that he's similar to that. Because of just
Chance know what I'm talking about.
Damn.
D Smoke. What's the name of
Chance
that fucking show?
Chance doing it. Chance said, yo, I know that nigga Justin Bieber got a following.
That's a fact.
There you go. That's cool.
Don't
Chance got a
chance like that.
But what I'm saying is, he changed his style. If you go back and y'all watch that shit I said I wanted to enter y'all into, that little competition, it was him, Cardi B, and T.I. They was the host and shit, the show. There was a nigga on there.
I can't no more.
Yo, as a matter of fact, since
yo, this shit has fired me.
Real quick, D Smoke won the competition, video selection. Can you review that real quick? Just real quick. And you're going to understand what I mean when I say he copped his whole shit after that. Video selection, like how he paid attention to like his visual, like, you'll see. This shit holding on.
I don't get the point of this song or this video.
Mm-hmm.
But you chose it.
I've been trying to get you to turn this shit off.
You
didn't tell you something. I don't even want to fucking review B. Get that nigga out of here. He doesn't get a review.
Yo, bro, stop
why
playing.
Why niggas didn't say that before I even put it on?
Yo, how is Whoop their better video?
Dave made it. Their fucking effects guy made it. That's how. The fuck?
Yo, it's a way better video. The song is
trash. Yo,
alright,
so.
Like he a GTA character. It's
so,
a way better video.
This shit is hot garbage. Sorry. I don't know what this shit is for. Y'all know any bitches that would like this shit?
Check out the
I don't.
Rebellion video. It's just a
oh
way better video. I won't keep saying that shit.
Let's put that on the
table. But I want you to check out that shit that I said at one point, bro. If we have time.
So you gotta let me know about it? <that? laughs>
Look,
what that motherfucker said?
How we running out of time? Yeah, he said. He's
here.
Go.
Here we are.
Yo, we can't run out of time before we run out of blunts. That don't make no sense.
I really don't.
Bro, we still got another song. A couple of trailers to check out. You got to see what kind of fucking hood shit is going on in the world.
We're going to have to cut and edit.
And AJ got to cut some ass on these bitch-ass basketball players.
Here we go. Yo, Dave, we going to let you introduce this joint. You know why? Because you did it, and he had 21K. You heard?
Nah, you got to let him know. Let him know. Let him know what it is.
Kids, just play it. Look at my nigga. Shout out to him. Why you go like that? What y'all call
him? Shiny.
What's up, baby? He's asking you to introduce the song, brother.
Okay.
What, are you asking me?
Yes, bobblehead.
What the fuck am I introducing?
He's the creator of the video and the visual. The reason why you guys can understand and go see this visual today is because the man sitting behind that motherfucker came over there. I know you didn't see his face
chilling.
Much, but you can
I'm
see
I'm right
it.
Here.
There you go.
They it's see me.
Potato head right
talking
there.
Shit.
It's the effects guy, you heard?
Potato
Dave,
head.
The effects guy. Let me say it right.
I'm going to be like me. Yeah, y'all could call me Mr. Potato Head, a.k.a. Ice-T, a.k.a. the nigga in charge, a.k.a. the nigga that takes a shit, a.k.a. the nigga that wipes with the right.
Yo,
Mr. Every fucking thing.
Mr. Cut Your Ass.
Mr. I Need a Shape Up.
Oh. No beats.
That's fucked up.
Alright,
let's go.
A motherfucker like me need a shape up with a lawnmower.
Alright.
Lawnmower? I think you was being considerate.
Alright, so last week we flamed the boss. This week
we catching all that flame.
So across this episode, every time he gets flamed, we just gonna put a bunch of fires in his head. Sure. You gonna hear that shit go up like that, alright? I don't know who's gonna get flamed next week. We'll see. Who will be the target? Well, what we got going on here, Mr. Finesse?
Alright, well, since Dave don't want to talk about it, we're going to pull out Rebellion. It was, what, Kingpin's second single, right?
Actually, this was our first
one. First one, I thought, what's the name was? No Weapon.
Yeah, that. No Weapon was the second.
No Weapon was the second, okay, so this is the first single right here. So,
first single we pushed with hard promotion, and, you know, shit like that, but yeah.
So,
let me tell you a little bit about it, since he's a little choked up.
It's your soul.
It's actually called Rebellion for many of you who may not know. We're at 21K right now on YouTube. We're about 16K on Spotify, you know, 40K throughout Facebook, you know. So it's been seen by, you know, a few people. And it's myself, E-Dash Quater, featuring Bless, BL355, and Prince Anthony. And it's pretty much about, you know, the Black Lives Matter movement, baby. And that's always going to matter to us. No matter what time, date, you know, it's always going to be of importance. Why? Because we are Black nature. We come from that. You feel me? So it's always going to be first on our list. And without further ado, this is Rebellion. You feel me? So we're going to review this. And, you know, hopefully y'all give us y'all feedback too and let us know what y'all think.
My voice right now is standing.
That was the bro BL355 featuring E-Dash Quaid and Prince Anthony as well. With Rebellion. We're gonna apologize for this Wi-Fi interruption we having right now. But y'all get the chance, y'all go out there and y'all definitely look it up. But we could definitely discuss it since we already know what the fuck the video about. We made it, you feel me? We wanted y'all to sit here and view this with us, but because y'all really can't, we gonna just let y'all know what's on. So you feel me? I guess I could kick it off. Initially when we wrote the joint, me and the bro was downstairs in the crib chilling, you feel me, like we normally do. And we was going through some beats and shit. We came across this joint, and right now at that time, Ryan, you can just imagine everything at the high, at its peak, you feel me, when we going through this shit. So we seeing, you know, the George Floyd movement, you feel me, we seeing the marches, and this is right before the riots and shit hit, you feel me, like right before the riots hit and shit, you feel me. So you can see like just the anger of the city and the world, really, because this shit is like worldwide on the news everywhere. And me and the bro just sitting downstairs like, god damn, you see this shit that's happening to this brother and everything that's happening out here? I'm like, yeah, bro. I'm like, yo, we gotta write something, bro. We gotta really do something to this, you feel me? He like, fuck it, put on a beat. So we scrolling through, and the next beat we happen to put on happened to be this, you know what I mean? And it was called Black Panther, if I'm not mistaken. Yep. And it was just perfect. You feel me? The name of the beat was Black Panther. And then as soon as I heard it, I got on my Black Panther shit. You feel me? For real. You feel me? And so did the bro. You feel me? And then, you know, that's how Rebellion came about. But, yeah, that's the discovery and the creation of Rebellion.
Time out. Who told Prince not to get in here? Come on for that shit.
That's crazy.
Yeah, that's another topic he did, actually.
That's
he
a fact.
What the fuck?
Hey,
Dash. She's
waiting
Island
Girl.
Fake ass Michael Jackson.
Didn't your wife make the shirts?
Mm-hmm.
She made the shirts for the video.
Yeah, definitely. You know, I'm not. Big shout out to Queen Pen. Queen Pen on my King Pen production, but she has her own shit. And everything that you see in the video, the clothing, you feel me? The outfits, the jean jackets, the jeans, the shirts, she actually made by hand. On her own dolo. So, you know, for everybody in here, and she does this on the regular, so y'all could definitely check her out at Queen Pen Glow on Instagram and Facebook, you feel me? If y'all into any handcrafted and customized designs, you feel me? You bring your joint, you pick a design, we'll make it glow. That's another thing about it. It fucking glows. That's the best part about it. In the dark or in the black light, everything we make glows. You know what I mean? That's just like our kicker. So come get your glowing design and clothes and apparel and accessories, whatever you may need. We do everything. We even do the walls. We do more. So, you know, come check out. But I mean, back to Rebellion. Much love to baby. Back to Rebellion, man. yeah, so that's the type of way we're doing. When I wrote the hook, you ready to die for what you believe in? That pretty much meant like, you know, are we ready as a race, as a people, you feel me, as a nation? Are we ready to really die for what we believe in? And everybody say that, and we all had different beliefs, but at that time we was in unison, and everybody had one strong movement, that MLB movement, you feel me? Everybody was in sync. So when I wrote that line, that's pretty much what I was talking about. Just like everybody getting ready for what we believe in as a people. We can move like this, just be so powerful. And that's the way it looked, you feel me? I'm not gonna go through every line, but I'm gonna pick certain lines out that just touch me, you feel me? And you know, in my verse, when I was like, like I said, it was at the high point of the riots and shit like that, and shit getting broken into in the communities, everybody was going crazy, jewelry stores, police everywhere, niggas fighting the police, they shooting shit every night. It was just wicked, you feel me? Especially in the Bronx, I don't know, man, I know, but Fort Road was like the high point. Shit,
yeah, I was out there, man.
It was wicked,
I was out there, too.
So, and we live right around the corner from, like, literally, nigga.
Stop playing, AJ. You out there? What you got?
You walk up my building and walk to everything man. That got hit. You feel me?
Word.
So, yeah, man, you know.
Morning.
And we seen all that shit, and then there was a part of my verse when I was like, you know, I'm cool with everything that we fighting for, we represent as a people. But now, let's not give these niggas any double standards to go by. For them to be able to say, yeah, we matter, but then we go fuck up on the only shit that we have, you feel me? It ain't ours, we don't own
that's
it,
true.
But it's in our community, you feel me? It's not like we went to fucking you know, what I saw for the most part is every fucking place that was raided or ran into was a black community. It wasn't like y'all went into the white community within your state and did that shit. You feel me?
It was our own town, you know, our own places that we hang out.
Right.
Yo, keep it on stack, bro. I really want to talk about that because that was crazy. That was crazy, bro. I walked to Times Square and that was crazy when I saw what y'all did.
Times Square, they hit fucking 34th Street.
Block of where we just chill and hang out, bro.
See, but then when you think about it right there, that's
what was the point of that?
That's the hidden unity of it, right?
That's over there.
Because what is ours is also everyone else's.
Don't get me twisted, bro.
I done chilled out in Times Square and 34th Street. That ain't my hood, but I feel like it is.
It is because we chill there on a regular basis, bro. That's somewhere we go and we be like, yo, let's go with the group,
bro,
let's go with the gang, and we chill.
I'll call you when I'm done.
That is a fact. I mean, you know, let's be honest. Some white people belong out here. They good custies.
Anyway.
Yeah, I know, yo, some of the best people I've met in my life.
I'm not gonna hold you.
Them trips I told you, talking about going to fucking, what's we call it, to a black camp. Guess who drove me from New York to Chicago and Minnesota? Some white people. Guess who funded my trips? White people.
That's a
fact. Guess who gave me a chance to see something else in my neighborhood? Some white people. So guess who was in a church teaching us shit? Some white people. So I'm not gonna never take away from white people. But I'm not gonna never let them put themselves above us, neither.
That's the thing, man.
And overall,
you know what I'm saying? I got love for them, but
good white people. But for the most part, a lot of them are fucked up.
There's
I'm
never nothing.
Gonna allow them to get one up on us. You feel me? Just as a black man in general. So yeah, I love those who've been kind and good-hearted to me throughout my life. But I have no passion or feeling for anyone who has any hate against my race. You feel me? But yeah, my bad, blessed not to take up all the time.
Nah, it was cool.
Go ahead, bro.
Yeah, more or less, y'all really know. Rebellion definitely was an emotional effect. You know, it definitely was inspired by time. What we was going through, the riots, you know, the police brutality, which has been going on for years, but it was just never brought out to light. And in my verse, I just basically was just letting people know that I'm one of the individuals, one of those that we don't have many of, that's willing to stand up and put his life on the line for something that's right, you know. Meaning, when I say right, meaning right everything as far as us, our freedom, our integrity, our respect, our everything. That's basically what inspired me. You're not in business today, you
know? I'm sitting here listening because I'm dead. I'm remembering the whole scenario, you feel me?
Somebody gotta get rid of this kid, man. That you act too tight, take that shit off. Especially if you gonna act a fool next to me.
Yeah,
man.
For real.
You be talking about them tight.
Motherfucker trying to give Prince some competition and
you're
shit.
You're definitely stuttering on thoughts right
yeah.
now.
Yeah.
But you know,
let's think about that for a minute.
One of the few that we have that is here to stand up. You know, I'm at the protest. You know, I'm not really with the rioting and stuff because, like, as the brother was saying earlier, that didn't really affect. I mean,
put your fist down, man. You need a goddamn face
looting,
over there.
People were getting caught looting. And they were getting their ass whipped by police. And nobody was helping them.
Whoa. Hold up. I saw some great videos of motherfuckers getting caught by police and some other cat drop a goddamn garbage can on him.
Mm-hmm.
Right there in Fordham, too.
What?
They did not let the other people get arrested.
I missed that.
I saw a lot of crazy things out there.
Oh, yeah.
Some people got their ass whipped that night. You know what I'm saying? And then y'all hit. Stores y'all hit. All right, I understand y'all hitting businesses and stuff like that. But then the same people, and I'm sure you were, the same people that went out there and for? I'm not saying you may make fun of my
eyes. He's looking at you and the camera.
You dead looked at me, bro. What the fuck? Look at me.
Oh, that's fucked up. Yo, Adrian's like, yo, your eye wandered a little bit too far.
Yo.
Yeah.
But, you know, he did, that's what
he said.
I mean, you know.
See if you can pull up that Batman trailer. See if you can let that shit load. See if you can pull up the Batman trailer and let it load for a second.
I mean, what about hood people like me, nigga?
What about hood people like you? What happened? What are you talking about?
Dude was hitting the fucking Akis, bro. Like, y'all took...
Yo, for real, down the block, there was no reason for that shit.
No grabber, bro.
That's exactly what I'm talking about. You feel me?
That's exactly.
No grabber, bro.
There was no reason.
Yo, y'all didn't understand the problem of having no...
But I was out there, right? And they had,
the
cops, the cops were... I was out there on Fordham. I got some video and shit.
Wait a minute, bro. But they hit flower shops. What you do, take
yeah, for real. Like, for real.
It wasn't Valentine's Day.
There was no reason. No reason to Valentine.
See, like, all right, y'all took
no reason
ATMs,
to
have
tea about
all the new clothes. All
right, cool, but flower shops, my man. Like,
yo, they took all that shit. I didn't see not one person selling anything. I was out there looking,
shit.
Too.
And me and the bro was out there. We deaded all that shit.
Niggas was not having that.
All that shit, man. They little mobcamp, they little shit. They look like they was ready to run in that shit. They was just happening to be in there. I think it was just us two. You feel me? And we helped Leo down or whatever. You feel me? For the night or whatever. But as soon as it happened, on our corner, they come saying, because you know what, they make my food every morning. Nigga, my good sandwich every morning. Faithful nigga. So you know, but
new stuff like that I didn't agree with, so I wasn't really with all the rioting and the looting, but I was with everything else, the hitting the precincts and flipping the cars, and you know, because that was the statement. They were the enemies. People weren't targeting the enemies, you know what I'm saying? We have to learn
we still don't target the enemies.
We basically, the enemies actually got run over, because instead of them doing it to us, we get to ourselves.
Here's the thing, they were just tricking us into thinking that this was a racial battle. Never a racial battle. It was government against citizen, bro. You feel me? And motherfuckers took this shit and they tried to spin it and flip it. Why? Because, yeah, most of the fucking government officials or people who were given power by government officials that were doing the corrupt shit were white. But there are plenty of times, nigga, in my own hood where the cops are predominantly the race that you are. You feel me? And they fuck you up too, nigga. They'll shoot you too.
Facts,
you feel me? The same color as you. So it wasn't about color. It was about right and wrong, and people versus government.
Who can enforce what's right and what's wrong?
Right, and people versus government. You feel me? Where I was getting to, bro. You feel me? And the thing is, we put the government in power to have power and rule over us in the wrong way. We don't take the time to say, all right, this person, we're going to allow this person to govern our communities. Then we're going to make sure it's the right person they're doing the shit. You feel me? But the shit been so far fetched off now, it's no saving this shit. It's been going on too long, nigga. Like, what can you do? When people really don't know shit, don't even know about votes, don't even stuff that you say matter, now we know don't matter because a nigga could rig votes. Like, what even gives a fucking person the motivation to go out and vote when you know your shit might get no chance of even going through? You feel me? So, like, we gotta take all this shit into consideration. It's never been...
That actually goes into another part of my verse that I want to elaborate on. The Congress, how the government been lying to us, rigging the votes, telling us that we're free and we were never really free. You know, these is all the things that inspired the verse. You know, all everything that we've been going through. Like, this is the time for a song like Rebellion. And I would inspire, God, people's famous.
Shit, wicked, bro. Shit wicked.
I'm lit, homie. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to tell them to leave me alone while we broken, but they still bother me. Whatever that is, I'm also on something. Nah, I didn't even that type of
thing. Well, <You're wrong. laughs> nah, you know?
And be here, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, bro, this shit's wicked,
it's
bro.
This shit's really wicked. So, Batman, I see that ugly ass nigga right there on the screen. I want to see this.
All right. Cool. So, we off that, yeah, but y'all get a chance, go check out Rebellion on YouTube. You know what I mean? You can check it out on a couple different YouTube channels. You can check it out on Retro Millennial. You can check it out on Blast
BLG55. It's gonna come up. Yeah. Type in Rebellion, it's gonna pop up.
Kingpin Productions. And you know, you can check us out on Spotify. You can check us out on every major platform. You feel me? We have a host of different list, a long list for y'all to go through and hear some good shit, you feel me? Go check Bless out on SoundCloud, you feel me? Where else you at, bro? Where else you at, bro? SoundCloud.
Reverb.
Reverb Nation.
Apple Music. I'm everywhere. SoundCloud, Reverb, YouTube, Facebook, Instagram.
Likey, nigga.
Likey. Everywhere.
All right, you heard? So, yeah, y'all just check it out. But, right.
Know it. Yeah, okay. And I definitely got my pal over here, Thumb. You ever had a human thumb? That's what that nigga look like.
Oh, man.
Oh, shit.
I fucked up.
About thumb. Yeah, remember thumb.
Let's get into this Batman trailer shit.
Right, so yeah.
Hey, y'all want to see a real life Batman person?
What's going on with the Batman fire movie? Bang, bang.
Just shot hammer.
And we got Coke skateboard brand. Leave that your shit.
Oh, wait. That was AJ. Don't tell me that was an AJ. Hold up. Wait. Hold up. Wait. Take it back if you can.
Sucks. What's that?
Wait, see. Yeah. That was 2 on point, nigga. He like hits from the streets.
Why would you try to test this shit with your fucking slow ass laptop and Wi Fi?
This is not my Wi Fi.
You trying.
But
bring her back.
From your secret friend.
Batman trailer, right?
Oh yeah, we got the Batman trailer coming up.
It's the new Batman?
Oh yeah, this is new shit.
2021, this shit come up.
Having a clue. Let's play a game, just me and you. Any of this mean anything to you?
What? Oh, go check it out, son.
You're becoming quite a celebrity.
Oh, we got a black Jim Gordon now.
If you are justice, please do not lie. What is the price for your blind eye?
The hell are you supposed to be?
Ass whooping.
Regular Batman shit.
Regular Batman shit?
This nigga look like, this nigga that's playing Batman look like he should play Joker though. Or Riddler or something.
Hey, Riddler's in this movie.
Yeah?
Yeah.
This movie fight. I already don't like it. I'm not gonna hold you.
Huh?
I already don't like it.
Why?
Compared to other Batman movies, I don't like it.
This is what you're not getting,
love
right?
Batman.
They're trying to make this shit like the movie Seven, where the Riddler's just murdering motherfuckers and driving Batman crazy.
Why? What are your views?
I'm a cool Batman fan, so I fuck with all the characters of Batman. You feel me? Every single one. The Riddler was probably one of my favorite villains.
Hold up, did you catch Catwoman?
No, I didn't see
Bring it back. Bring it back. Take another shot at this. Take another shot at this. Bless wasn't even paying attention. Take another shot at this.
I thought it was Batgirl, but he said it's Catwoman. So that's what I thought it was actually Batgirl.
They haven't never put a Batgirl in
there. Yeah, they did.
And that shit was terrible.
It was a terrible movie, though.
Oh, my God.
It was a bad movie.
What the fuck?
It was with Frost. No. She was horrible.
Oh, man.
I think we got another one.
Skip ads.
It's a freeze out.
Replay.
Stop. What? No, we won.
That shit went back to the middle.
Oh, shit. You're becoming quiet, so never seen.
Mister? I bet you like Marvel movies.
No, I love both movies. I actually like DC more than Marvel.
All right.
The fact they made Marvel movies for DC.
I don't know. They're releasing that Snyder cut.
I love them both too, man. You get what you get out of both. Mm-hmm. Marvel movies be better. I'm not gonna lie.
Marvel movies just better.
Batman has some killer.
They're definitely not cinematically better.
Yeah. Let's play a game. Just me and you. Marvel, I mean, cinematically, he means
cinematically, honestly, Infinity War got it.
Whoa, the boss is here. We on the last segment too.
But that's the same thing you guys. That's what I'm waiting for DC to do, because DC is building up to the same thing as well.
I don't want them to.
But they are. The first Justice League already came out.
Huh?
So the second movie's coming out.
What?
The first Justice League already came out. So the second movie.
It failed. That's why they're releasing the Snyder cut on HBO. There you go, it's Catwoman in there.
Sorry? Yeah. I see the way she was drilling into the shit.
Okay, those are hands though. Right there. That's what I like about this Batman. This Batman showed that he got straight hands.
Oh, for real.
None of your other Batman's vengeance.
Hold up, whoa, my man Ben Affleck.
Ben Affleck did, yeah.
Oh.
He got wicked.
Ben Affleck definitely did.
He got wicked.
He got wicked with it.
He really did.
Honestly, I think he was probably the best Batman.
He's a bad Batman.
Yeah. Physically.
I'm still
with my nigga Michael Keaton.
Yeah, he got real busy though.
Gonna be in the Flash movie apparently.
Yeah. He the one who got super busy, Michael Keaton.
Facts.
He fucked niggas up. I'm Batman. This nigga, bro. You feel me?
But yeah, nah. That's what I'm saying. I don't want them to do what Marvel does. Marvel's too cookie cutter. Not like I don't fuck with it. But Marvel's done for. They ain't got. They don't have anything after the Infinity Gauntlet.
Well, they're already planning to do a whole different saga. But I hate the fact that
for what? Things. For what? It's either gonna be.
It's a movie they're doing.
No, no, no. That's fine.
Women
oh, so we're gonna get into that one.
Still
come through.
So they're gonna have a bunch of yeah,
right.
Yeah, a bunch of those crazy women.
But they should have been to that, bro. I thought it didn't make no sense for them.
That's what they said. That's one of the reasons why they made Shuri Black Panther.
Not a Cyclops.
I don't
movie.
Mind that,
you
but
a, you don't have a Storm movie Cyclops.
Remember that scene?
Hold up, wait. That's what they're planning on doing. That's what they're planning on doing now. They're gonna
have another Storm.
No,
movie.
No. They're gonna have a mutant in every new Marvel movie. So Storm's gonna be in the new Black Panther movie.
Perfect.
That's how they're gonna introduce the X-Men into the world since they bought them.
Perfect. Now you talking good shit.
And if they can make that world
because think
work,
about it, they already did
in,
it.
She was in one already, too.
See, they need to do
point.
That, though.
Maybe the flash
that'll catch.
Yeah, about,
because they don't have anything else.
But
if they catch the kind of, like, racism that the X-Men have to go through in this day and age, that shit will keep them alive for another 10 years.
X-Men shit, ain't nothing gonna get better than that, bro. Ever.
I'm
sorry. X-Men was always my favorite.
So they said Batman Affleck returns.
Ain't nothing
what?
Gonna get better
in
than X-Men because you have so many mutants, bro.
You're lying.
It's like mutant African.
Wait. You're lying. Look.
What?
Batman Affleck returns Flashpoint. Explain. You're lying. They're not gonna bring him back.
Maybe we can.
They're bringing him back.
Next one.
Ooh.
He just said it though. He said apparently he's gonna get the next Flash movie.
Have the courage to change the name.
I'm gonna bring this shit back.
You can't. And have the wisdom to know the difference.
I don't know. I really wasn't really a big Flash
fan. Oh, no. I love the Flash.
I like him. But I wasn't really, I like Superman better than the Flash. Them niggas racing around the world.
They did too much with the Superman of the comics. That's why they stopped liking Superman. So I make him learn how to turn back time and all that shit.
I tell you right now for a fact, right? Marvel would have zero chance
against DC.
Against DC, if they did the cartoons live action,
zero chance.
Right? You watch. You don't like the Flash? Watch Flashpoint.
What, exactly. Watch Flashpoint. How you really
done?
The Flash get right.
Yeah, done.
You talking about the Netflix series?
No, it's an independent cartoon.
Okay. I like the cartoon.
Those shits are insane.
I didn't like all the Flash cartoons. I'm talking about when it got down. Now this movie I might like. But the series on Netflix, I really didn't like.
See, but they're trying to remake the cartoon into this shit. They succeed.
You didn't like that series with Savitar?
Marvel's done.
What?
That's the end to it. To watch the whole series.
That's probably why. You didn't get into the whole series. It took me a minute to get past the first two episodes.
It might be a fan cut. Nah, it's not.
Is a
fan club. Oh, wow, they really just vanished.
Oh. Wasn't
even a fan
club.
It's fan made.
You know,
I look like the dude
from that. We gotta talk about this shit next week.
We
gotta head up to Marvel and DC World next week.
Have to skip sports because unfortunately you can't fuck with the boss
because
the boss
is tired. You
also
have
to
boss is tired.
Guys,
it's
been a fun evening.
That's right, guys.
Definitely
been
fun. Had a lot of fun
today. Yeah.
It's
definitely been fun.
Let it
happen.
So now we on the sign out. You feel me? It's been a great episode.
That's a fact.
Half an hour is
coming through.
Today.
That Feel Justin Bieber song, that shit gets...
Trash.
Trash.
That shit gets five knee foreheads.
That shit gets my spear.
That shit is horrible.
Two days
pimples, five of knees foreheads.
So bad.
Three of AJ's feet.
Somebody gotta take out his legs.
That shit gets that shit four bless. Fucking bless his eye.
Now you know.
That shit is horrible.
What's really good? Do you wanna get high? Do you wanna get high? Tell me where we're at. What's really good? Do you wanna get high? Do you wanna get high? Tell me where we're at. What's really good? Do you wanna get high? Relax and listen to this melody. The best of me smoking and choking on serenity. It makes me a better me smoking on the loud. And I'm walking through the clouds in the sour smelling. Where my niggas at? Black market money. Where my killers.